everyone, I'm Candace.
I'm Arthur.
And I'm Vivian, and welcome to What's New with Microsoft 365 in November.
This month, we cover new features and updates to support you and your users, like
the availability of polls in Microsoft Teams to help conduct more engaging, informative, and productive meetings.
Microsoft Endpoint Data Loss Prevention, which lets organizations enforce policies to identify and prevent risky sharing of sensitive information.
Web capture and Edge to easily capture what's on your browser, and more. So let's get started.
First up, we're excited to share that thanks to the Forms integration in Teams, users who are meeting presenters can now create polls in advance and launch them during meetings that attendees can easily view and answer.
Presenters can choose settings, such as keeping responses anonymous, or close the poll so that it's no longer accepting responses. Polls are a great way to turn passive listeners into active and engaged participants.
Also, when the poll's published, it'll pop up on the respondent's meeting screen, as well as in the meeting chat, so it's easy to see the results. For less structured meetings, where advanced planning isn't needed, attendees can create ad hoc polls while a meeting's happening to get feedback on the spot.
Polls for Teams meetings has largely rolled out, but just as a heads up, it should finish rolling out in early December. To get started with it, make sure the Teams app is updated for your organization and that the Forms app has also been added to meeting tabs.
Another feature now available in Teams meetings is the ability to reduce background noise with noise suppression. Whether it's construction outside or people in your home just making really loud noises, both of which I can fully relate to, this automatic and real-time noise suppression helps reduce unwelcome background noise during meetings, making it easier to focus on presenters during distracting environments.
While it can be challenging at times sharing a space with my roommate, I love the fact that I save an hour each day from my commute to the office.
Noise suppression works by analyzing an individual's audio feed and uses specially trained deep neural networks to filter out noise and retain only the speech signal. To learn more about this feature, check out the blog post in the description.
Also new in Teams this month, the Power Automate app is now available. This app provides a lightweight designer experience and many different templates to help users get started with building workflows right in Teams. Power Automate will also make it easier to optimize repetitive processes by automating routine tasks, like if you want to automatically schedule one-on-one calls or set up approval flows.
And speaking of Power Automate, Microsoft Dataverse is a low-code data platform that helps users build apps and bots in Teams without needing to connect to storage, manage integrations, or switch applications.
Dataverse, which also supports the Power Apps in Teams, also has built-in security and governance features, which creates seamless control of access to apps, bots, and flows, as well as their underlying data. For more information about Power Automate in Teams, Dataverse, and more news related to the Power Platform, check out the link in the description.
The ability to protect and manage data is critical to any organization, and now it's more important than ever for admins supporting remote and hybrid work scenarios. That's why we're pleased to share that Microsoft Endpoint Data Loss Prevention, or Endpoint DLP, is now available.
This solution enables organizations to enforce policies that identify and prevent risky or inappropriate sharing, transfer, or use of sensitive information across cloud and on-premise endpoints.
To learn more about Endpoint DLP, including an upcoming public preview, like adding enforcement actions and locations-based sensitivity, or a new dashboard in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center to manage alerts, check out the blog post and documentation in the description below.
For Microsoft Edge, we have two new features we want to call out to help increase users' productivity. The first is Web Capture in Edge, which lets you easily capture and mark up web content.
To get started in your browser, select Settings and More, or the three dots, and then select Web Capture. Then, drag a box to select what you want to capture, even if you need to scroll, and then just release your selection to capture it. You can draw on it to mark it up, or share if you want.
The second update is there's a new My Feed section on the Enterprise New Tab page for users. This customizable feed features news and information from a user's favorite content providers and sits right next to their work and files. It's designed to keep users connected to information most relevant to their industry or your company.
For users who'd want to hear their document read aloud, Read Aloud is now available for Word on Android, as well as Word on the Office app for Android. The new voices for Read Aloud offer a more natural and pleasant listening experience, which lets users easily pause and resume Read Aloud, as well as adjust their voice speed.
To get started, open the Word or Office app on an Android phone, go to the Review tab, and then tap Read Aloud.
Contoso and Northwind have a long and trusted relationship that spans more than 3 decades.
For users who are working with notes across various endpoints, like OneNote or Sticky Notes, they might find it helpful to have their notes sync across these different platforms and appear in one accessible and convenient feed.
Now, with the OneNote feed, users can actually do this. This feature combines notes across Sticky Notes, recent OneNote pages, and even Samsung Notes, so users can easily reference them all while composing an email or working in OneNote.
For example, say the user is working in OneNote and they want to create a sticky note to reference later for an email. They can create and add that sticky note to the OneNote feed, and all without having to leave OneNote itself.
To get started in OneNote, users should select the Open Feed icon in the top right corner of the app to display the feed pane. The OneNote feed is available in OneNote, OneNote on the web, OneNote for Windows 10, Outlook on the web, and Outlook.com.
And that's a wrap on this episode. To read more about all the great features and updates we covered today, make sure to check out the links in the description below.
And while you're down there, don't forget to like this episode and leave a comment. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. The holidays are coming up, and we want to wish you a safe and happy, fun time.
As always, thank you so much, everyone, for watching and sharing your thoughts on all the features we've been covering. We really appreciate our viewers, and we want to wish you a safe holiday season in the weeks ahead. Take care, and we'll catch you next time. Bye.
Bye.